Today, I'll be making a hangboard for 1/10 what it costs online. And just so everyone's on the same page, a hangboard is what rock climbers use to increase grip strength. You hang on the board and over time you get stronger. That's why it's called a hangboard. Originally, I was just gonna buy one of these, but I mean, that's way too expensive. So instead, because I don't value my time, I'll be spending the next 4 weeks building one myself. Let's do this. The first thing I needed was some wood. I got this donated from Deadwood Revival. It's maple and it's nice. The only problem is that it's way too thin, so I had to cut it in half so I could glue two slabs together and make it thick enough. You'd think that gluing two slabs of wood together would be easy. You'd be wrong. I had to make sure they were completely flat so that the faces would meet correctly, which means I ran it through the planer a ton just to get it smooth enough. Eventually, I got it figured out though, and while that's drying, let's talk design. While I could have come up with a design of my own, I think it's probably easier and smarter just to steal a design that already works. I'm talking about the Beastmaker 2000. This thing's legit. It's $150 of perfection. Except that it's $150. So instead, went to Reddit and I found all the correct depths for the cuts, and then I just went into Rhino, which is the CAD software I use, and I modeled it myself. It's not exactly perfect, but it's about as close as I could get. Now is where my secret plan comes to life. Instead of cutting all of this intricate geometry myself, I'm just gonna make a machine do it for me. This is a CNC machine, and it's sweet. A CNC machine can take a tool path that I set up and cut it exactly as I've told it. They charged me $15 to use it, but I'm okay with that price compared to the alternative. This machine has two stages, the rough pass where it chunks out as much material as possible, and the finishing pass where it gets refined to a much cleaner finish. And it's pretty satisfying, so just give me a moment to enjoy this. Now that it's complete, I just had to cut the piece out and we've got a hangboard. Okay, now that I've got the whole thing roughed out, all I have to do is clean up all of these jagged lines. I don't know if you can see it or not, but the CNC machine, while it is smooth, it's not perfectly smooth, and I want it to be perfect. So I kept going. First order of business was sanding, like a lot of sanding. While I'm doing this, now's a good time to say that if you've enjoyed the video so far, consider subscribing. I've got a lot more projects in the works.
This is before and after. It's nice.
I was informed by Reddit that you're supposed to round over your hangboard, otherwise your fingers get like hurt and stuff, and I don't want to hurt my fingers, so I started on that. I decided to go with like a contrasting theme of the lower half and the upper half, which is the lower half is rounded over and the top half is routed for a 45 degree chamfer, I think is what it's called. I don't really know how to explain why I chose this, but just that I thought it'd look cool, so that's what I did. There we go. I'd say that's better. I just gotta do it for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 more. Oh shoot, I think it's done.
With the wood all routed out and cleaned up, I decided to wood burn it, which is kinda risky. Actually, it's kinda really risky. You may be wondering why I'm doing this, and it's because
I've been at this for so long with this little gadget I made, and it's not helping at all. Look at this. There's still loads of burn marks. I think I might just leave it and pretend it's a feature.
So instead of fighting it all day, I just decided to go with it. And I burned those spots and then I burned around the bottom edges just so it had a nice ombre, like as the gradient moves up. And it'll be cool. You just gotta wait till I stain it and then I promise you it looks a lot better than it does currently.
I don't know if I ruined it or made it better.
But we're getting real close to finished. So what I did was I added a little logo on top, some mountain designs, just so it's simple and it's thematic and it fills up that space nicely. And with that done, all I have to do to finish it is finish it. Let's just enjoy this part. I'm gonna stop talking so I don't kill you guys. I gave the finish a few days to dry, and I guess it's time to show you the final results. If you liked the video, consider subscribing. Here we go. Hey, lace them up, lace them up, lace them up, lace them. Blue suede shoes stay crispy like bacon. Nikes on my feet make my cipher complete. I stay shining like the lights on the street in the night. Revis take me shopping when I'm up in New York. Hit the shoe store, go and cop a few more. You at the mall getting dinner at the food court. I'm in LA eating 22. And the Nikes on my feet keep my cipher complete. Bike, 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 bike.